All right, thank you, Nathan. It is now time for Texas Face Off. Joining us today is Noel Candelaria with the Texas State Teachers Association and Matt Mackowiak, the chairman of the Travis County Republican Party. We thank you both for being with us today.
Thanks for having
us. Pleasure. Really big news for Texas teachers from the state capitol yesterday. Senate Bill 3, which would give every teacher in Texas a permanent state-funded $5,000 raise, was voted out of committee. That means it's going to go to the full Senate for a vote. Nat, we'll start with you. Teacher raises is something that I think politically no one can be against, right?
Sure, and obviously the state's economy has been very strong over the past 2 years. It's why the comptroller said we had more money to spend for this biennium. And both the governor, the lieutenant governor, and the speaker have all said teacher pay raises have to be part of how they're going to spend that money. The Senate bill, I think, puts about $4 billion towards it. Did get out of committee. We'll pass the Senate very soon. The question is, you know, what is the House going to do? Is it going to guarantee a raise at the same level? Is it going to dedicate the same amount of money overall? And how does that figure into the public school finance reform effort that's also working its way through the House and Senate as well? So, look, teacher raises are important for retention. They're important for recruitment. You know, as Lieutenant Governor often says, the most important person in a child's life outside the parent is the teacher that's in the classroom. And so it's time for teacher salaries to increase, and that's why you're seeing there being such bipartisan support for this.
Yeah, teachers have not received a state-funded raise in the last 10 years. So I just want to ask you, because you mentioned it going to the House. I mean, if the representatives were to be against this, I mean, that is just a bad move.
So it depends a bit on how they want to take. It looks like both sides want to put $8 to $9 billion more in education. Mm-hmm. How much of it they want to dedicate specifically to teacher pay raises versus you know, funding increases overall to the system, I think, is the question. What that breakdown is going to be. So yes, I do think there are going to be teacher pay raises. Whether it ends up being exactly $5,000 per mm-hmm. teacher, I think, remains to be seen. It could be a little less.
Yeah. No. One of the things that I think is interesting is while there were a lot of people who spoke in favor of the bill yesterday, we did hear people talk about this needs to be for not just teachers, that they want to see librarians, custodians, bus drivers. All these people are not making the living wage, and that was one of the things that they asked lawmakers to consider. Your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's really important for us and for all educators that work tirelessly day in and day out supporting our teachers in the classroom. The success of the teacher is not the teachers themselves, right? It's everything that goes into preparing the classrooms, getting the kids to school, making sure that they have, you know, healthy, nutritious meals, our support staff in the front office. I mean, everything that makes the entire school system work and succeed for our students, so that when they walk into a teacher's classroom, everything is set and ready to go. So supporting a pay raise for all the employees is really important this session.
Yeah, but the likelihood that that is going to happen, what do you think?
Well, I mean, I think, you know, what we're advocating for is a straight across teacher pay raise, but that the legislature also appropriate funding for pay raises across the board for school districts to then be able to allocate to meet the needs in their communities. Because if you look at a community like Austin, the cost of living is really high. And so, you know, the districts don't have the resources at the moment to adequately pay all employees a living wage for their community. And so, you know, straight across teacher pay raise is great, but we also need to make sure that the appropriate dollars for pay raises and health care, which is also a big issue amongst educators across the state of Texas.
You know, obviously this plays into the bigger picture of school finance and what we're going to do to address school finance. The governor, lieutenant governor, speaker of the House have all said this is a major priority. The speaker said it's his only priority for this session. And when we look at what Texas spends, the state spends just 38 cents to every dollar to educate children in Texas. How do you think they're going to go about, besides just putting more money in the system? Is that the only way to fix this?
Yeah, it's a great question. And school finance is probably the single most complicated issue at the Capitol. The formulas are impossible for even experts to understand. I think that there is widespread agreement that you can't do school finance and property tax reform separately. You have mm-hmm. to do them together. So obviously, if they're able to reform the property tax system, that's going to release some pressure on the school finance system. But the fact that they're taking, that the legislature is prepared to take the bulk of the money, the new money that's available, and put it towards these priorities, I think tells you how important it is. I do think that there is going to be more money going to the system, but I also think you're going to see greater accountability and greater transparency going forward that's going to be needed as well. So look, it's very complicated. There's not a clear plan yet that both sides are getting behind. In the House, you can't consider bills until 60 days, which we're not there yet. So this is a priority, and I think the fact that the leaders of the House, the Senate, and the governor all recognize that this has to happen, whether it's a regular session or a special session, has to happen this year is a good thing.
Yeah, so you brought up the property tax bill. We know that Senate Bill 2 slash House Bill 2 is the popular bill right now, and that would reduce the rollback rate to 2.5%. We have obviously heard cities, counties, and even some schools say that this is going to be really restraining on them. What are your thoughts on taking this to 2.5%?
I mean, I think that's really limiting local communities to make what's in the best interest for their making those decisions, those financial decisions, and really strapping them to that 2.5. When we've seen in other parts of the country, when they've done that historically, it's come back to bite them. When local communities, and the reason, we have to remember the reason why we're here in the first place, is the legislature over the last, since they cut $5.4 billion in 2011, has really placed a burden on the local communities to make up that difference. And so, you know, making sure that we're adequately funding our public schools first is a priority before we can address the property tax issue, which is a result of low funding of public education from the state legislature.
Yeah. Matt, 2.5, do you see it moving forward?
So we'll see. I mean, you've seen, it appears they're going to be maybe one vote short in the Senate on the 2.5% number with Senator Kel Seliger, the Republican from Amarillo, making clear he's not going to support it at that level. So it may go up a little bit. If you remember in the last legislative session, there was disagreement over 4% or 6%. Again, this doesn't say that the rate can't go above that. It just says that the counties or the cities have to go to the voters. And so if they have a case to make that they need to have it be above that rollback rate, they can make that case to the voters. Look, all these counties and all these cities should be seeing a growth dividend. They're seeing more money already because of significant population growth everywhere. And I think this legislature is saying property tax growth is out of control. It's 10, 15, 20% in some areas. That's not sustainable.
Yeah. All right. Well, it will certainly be interesting to watch. We thank you both for joining us this morning. We certainly appreciate it. Of course, you can catch this interview on KVUE.com after the show. We'll be right back.